Christos
Paraskevopoulos.
Paraskevopoulos is the artistic director of organ and music festival Rhodes, which has been running for some years. Please, Christos, speak us about your festival, how it was born, and what are the characteristics of this festival.
The Organ and Music Festival of Rhodes has been established at 2010 when I have been invited here from the Consul of Grand Britain, Rainer Kosioris. We are friends with Rainer Kosioris and she invited me to have an organ recital. After that, I thought that it was a very good idea to have the festival here, because the church is a very nice, church, and the organ that is in this church is the biggest in a church in the whole country.
So, the whole country in Greece or in Rhodes?
In country, in Greece, it's
in
the
Greece,
biggest
the organ
in the
of St. Francis Street.
Exactly, it's the biggest in the church. We have also the huge organ at the Athens Concert Hall that is five, six times more than that, but in a church, this is the biggest. And it also has a very good acoustic. So it was a chance for me to organize a festival here and invite some artists from the Rhodes Island and some artists from other places, from abroad, from Athens. And so all these years we had artists from Israel, Sister Anne Laurent that plays the organ at St. Sepulchre, Elenike Venzido that plays the organ in London, Stratos Urbanoglou, and also other artists from Athens.
And this year who performed in the festival?
This year we had artists from Rhodes, we had two choirs from Rhodes, one a very good soloist, a tenor soloist, that he lives and performs here. And we also invited a trumpeter from Athens Opera, from the Symphonic Orchestra of Athens. The Symphonic Orchestra of Athens Opera. So we had three concerts with all these artists. I thought that it had much success because, as you see, a lot of people came at the church. Yes. The church was full at the nave and sometimes at the other side. And I am very satisfied from the attendance of the audience and generally from the level of the festival.
The relationship with Francisca, how come? Because you spoke about the Great Britain Consul, but not about the role of Franciscan in this festival, of the Catholic Church in this festival.
Oh, yes, I have to speak also for Father Luke, of course, that he is a very nice priest, a very nice man, and he's an open-minded man, of course, because I am Orthodox, I'm not Catholic, but we believe in the same God, of course. We are all Christians, we are brothers. And he also invited me here, and I love this church, I love every human being that is in this church. So we are all brothers here, and we can have a good collaboration with each other. So our relationship, I think, as he also says, is very nice and marvelous. He's an organist also, he knows music, he knows the value, of course, of the music inside the church, the value of a festival that it just opens its doors to the audience, the Rhodian audience, so many people from the island and even from far away distances came to attend this festival.
Yes, so. And what are the plans for the future of this festival?
We want to make it bigger, of course, with more artists. We invite also people from other countries. Every time we need to have an organist from another country, even for another artist, but we need more people, of course, from other places of Greece, probably. That means that Rhodes Festival and the Church of St. Francis here must be known to more and more people from this country, even from other countries, as I said before.
He could become a point for the classical music, the church music in Greece.
Definitely, because there are no other festivals like that. I mean, they are festivals in Athens, of course. We have two festivals, but there are not sacred music or only organ. We use the organ, but not only for organ. The main purpose of this festival is to use the organ in every concert. So we think that is exactly a point for the organ music here, at the edge, in fact, of Greece.
And probably this is also the only festival in Greece with the organ, or not?
No, not exactly. There are other two in Athens. But you know, it's another place. I mean, Athens, it's a multicultural city with many, many millions of people. They have their view for the music, but here at Rhodes, it's much more different by the view of these people are not used in this kind of sacred music or organ music. The last 5 years, we had all this organ music, and the organ people even didn't know that they own the biggest organ in Greece. They didn't know that this church has an organ. And all these facts, we owe them to Father Luke, that who has restored this organ 8 years ago. This organ was obsolete. I mean, it was broken. We couldn't play for many decades. So Father Luke restored the organ, and after that the organ revived, and its music also, to the Rhodian audience. Newspapers of this, the local newspaper of this island, write every time many, many articles for this festival and the organ, and I think that this music must be in their hearts, as they also say every time that they leave the concert, that it was a very, very fabulous concert and we need you more times here. They love this music. So I think that its value is much more different than in Athens, that they know every kind of music.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome. Thank you very much also.